Hi guys, this is Vikas over here and you are watching We Are Genius. Guys, today I am again with a new video around Raspberry Pi. We will see how to interface DHT12 humidity and temperature sensor with Raspberry Pi by using Java and Pi4j. About DHT12, it is a temperature and humidity sensor with one wire as well as I2C interface to connect with external microcontrollers. And having one wire interface makes it compatible with older DHT11 sensor, as in terms of one wire interface both are having same protocol, but the DHT12 is having higher accuracy as compared to DHT11 sensor. So for this tutorial we are going to use I2C interface of the sensor, and to interact with it we'll be using Java. One issue with DHT12 I2C bus is that the device address is not changeable, which limits the multiple sensor interfacing to the same I2C bus, as you can't have different address for each of the sensor. So being said that, let's get started guys. So guys, as you can see over here, connecting DHT12 with Raspberry Pi is pretty much straightforward. You just need to connect BCC pin to 3.3 volt pin of Raspberry Pi, SDA goes to SDA pin, SCL goes to SCL, and ground is connected to ground pin of the 40 pin GPIO header of Raspberry Pi 3 or any other depending upon the version of Raspberry Pi you are using. So over here you can notice we have not used any pull up jumpers between SDA, SCL and BCC line, because the Raspberry Pi has got onboard pull up registers. So whenever you are working with I2C bus of Raspberry Pi, you don't need to connect external pull up jumpers. So let's make the connections quickly and we'll get back to Eclipse IDE and see how to interact with the DHT12 sensor by using Java and Pi4j. So guys, to start with the coding, let's open up Eclipse, or you can use any other IDE that you are familiar with, and create a new Java project. That is, let's say DHT12 Pi, and use the JRE version that is compatible with your Raspberry Pi operating system that you are using. Again, if you are new to Java application development for Raspberry Pi, you can check out my earlier tutorials on this, for which I have given the link down below in the description. Now on the project, let's create a new class. Let's say main class, and I'll be using the default package. Get finish. Now let's copy the code from my GitHub repository. You can just take the code from my GitHub repository, otherwise you can check out on my website. So let's copy this, paste it over here. And just change whatever required. And as I said earlier, I'm going to use Pi4j library for this. So you need to add Pi4j library to your class path. And I'm again doing it over here. Just click on OK. So if you are like working on Pi4j for first time, you can check out my earlier tutorial where you can see like how to download the library and use it in your project, for which as I said, I have given the link down below in the description. So this is a simple code, and let's have a walkthrough to the code. Over here I have just created one I2C device that is using the Pi4j I2C device. Then I have created a boolean, that means it will help me to debug, or the if I want to individually print out the packets received from the DHT12 sensor. Then is a simple print statement, and after that I have just initialized the I2C bus with the bus 1 of Raspberry Pi. Over here we are going to use the bus 1 of Raspberry Pi. If you are using older version or something, you can just check out for the particular version of Pi that you are using. Then after that we are initializing the device from the bus as the device having address 0x5C, and this is the address that corresponds to the DHT12 sensor. If you are and as I said earlier, this is not changeable. So to one I2C bus you can connect only one DHT12 sensor. After that I am just creating a array that will contain the return data from the DHT12 sensor, and you can see over here this has 5 bytes, and when you get into the data sheet of the DHT12 sensor, you can see over here on I2C bus it returns us 5 bytes, or you can read 5 registers of the DHT12 sensor, and the register contains the humidity for address 0x00. On address 0x01, it contains the decimal part of humidity. Similarly, for 0x02, it contains temperature, and 0.03 contains the decimal part of temperature, and 0.04 contains the checksum, which should be equal to all the values added, like the humidity, humidity decimal part, temperature and temperature decimal part. So over here you can see I'm just reading out 5 bytes from address 0.00. And if you are like new to this I2C and all, you can check out the Java docs of Py4j library for details how this works. So but basically 0.00 is the starting address. Data is the array we created that will hold the return data from the I2C device. 0 is the initial index of the buffer from where we want to store the data, and 5 is the number of bytes or number of registers we want to read out from the I2C device. And as you can see over here, if we have set X true, that means if you want to print out the data returned by this tutorial sensor, you can print out simply by data 0 up to data 4, that is 5 bytes of data. And I have over here commented out what which data corresponds to what. Then after that, we are just checking out the checksum. That means data 4 should be equal to sum of data 0, 1, 2 and 3. After that, if this comes out true, I am just converting the humidity and temperature data from 2 bytes of each data received from the DHT12 sensor. And over here, I am just converting the bytes into a string and then passing it as double values. So if you are aware of any other method, you can simply do that to convert the 2 bytes of data for each parameter to the corresponding double of float value you want. Then after that, I am simply printing out the humidity as well as temperature. So let's create one jar file out of it and we'll try to run on Raspberry Pi and we'll see if this works out. For that, I just need to run it once. Now as usual, when you run for the first time, you'll see error on your Windows system that because we are using native library for Raspberry Pi. So now just get into export, click on runnable jar file, then select the main class you want to use, then the output text jar file or whatever executable jar file name that you want. Now click on finish. Again, all this can be found on my earlier tutorial in detail, like how to select which option and why. So make sure to check out that one. Now after this, we'll get two files, one that is test.jar file and one is test_lib folder that contains all our libraries. Now let's open up WinSCP that will be used to transfer our files to the Raspberry Pi by using SSH. And after that, we'll try to run the files using SSH, using PuTTY. Now let's open up PuTTY. And now before running the file, just we need to transfer the files to Pi, and I'm just selecting the files that I want to transfer and hitting the upload button. And on the Pi side, you'll see the jar file as well as the lib folder. Now let's try to run the file that is using the command sudo java jar, then the path to the file, then the file name or the executable file name, that is test.jar. And you can see over here, it is successfully printing out the temperature and humidity data. You can just like refer to other sensor to try check out the accuracy of the sensor that we are having, DHT12. So that's all of this, guys. Hope you have enjoyed it. If so, hit the thumbs up button. And if you have not subscribed yet, you can definitely subscribe to my channel for latest updates and videos like this. So see you next time with my next video. Till then, goodbye.